okay, America, you're fucked up. Yeah, the reason why I'm saying, I'm not talking about most Americans in America right now, because I'm talking about the ones that want to kill the Muslims, you see? What you're planning to do is almost like what the Nazis did in World War II with the Jews. And everyone outside of Nazi Germany wanted to stop the Germans for what they're doing, and if someone like, oh, I don't know, Ted Nugent or Donald Trump gets elected, all the normal Americans will be moving out of America and going to come up here to Canada or Mexico or get the heck out of America until they get those two, those kinds of people who are running for president have to turn up so we can have someone like Obama in power again or Justin Trudeau in America. You see, my views are my own about the Muslims, because I respect their culture, their beliefs, and the Nijab, which I respect that for their religious beliefs, for women wearing the Nijab so they just cover your eyes for, and the bikini is illegal in their countries, but when they're in a Western country like Canada and America, I want them to show their face to the person who's wearing the hijab, show their face to see if they are actually who they are. I don't know if that person in that hijab is man or woman or two kids or a goat, but you see, that's all who I am, you see? Because I'm about my own safety. But I'm not, and because one person called me a racist because of one photo I've shown, and about my views to a point. And to also to you Americans, you have to think about the Muslims. Sure, their culture, their beliefs are a little bit different than yours, but they are human like you and me. Sure, and their beliefs, they share some similarities to our beliefs, and what they like to do might be kind of weird, but it might be similar to what we do. Like, I heard that some Muslims like to race camels. It's like horse racing in North America, and in Australia and Mongolia, which has a small percentage of Muslim people living there, they have camel racing, which is pretty awesome, mind you. I see those kind of, that kind of thing in North America from time to time. Just having that, something to get people to a certain area of America, like, have in somewhere in California, have camel racing, or in Mexico, in the Baja California, in the Baja region, why not have? They'll help out with the economy, because I care. That's what America should talk to, help out with the economy and not care about the Muslims. Sure, ISIS is bad, but you know what? That's just a small portion of the Muslims right there, because the ones that I want to do bad to the planet, like ISIS, those are the bad ones, but the ones that come to America, have give a little piece of their own culture to you, as in part of their restaurant or a convenience store that specializes in the country's snacks or food, you know what? I want to have them instead of a terrorist living next door to me. Because I can, and if I have a block party, I can invite the Iraqi, the the Muslims who are might be from Iraq or Pakistan, and let them bring their specialty dishes so I can have a nice ethnic style of barbecue. Have a shawarma there with a black bean casserole from Latin America, have American cuisine and all these different styles, just to have a nice melting pot of fun for that one day. And the reason why I'm saying this, America, stop being judgmental to the Muslims. Well, like I said, excellent them, the Muslims are evil, but not all Muslims. You have to think like that. You have to use your heart instead of hearing what Ted Nugent or Donald Trump is saying about the Muslims. Heck, there's some big famous people who are Muslim that people respect. There's Muhammad Ali, who is one of the greatest boxing champions of all time, mind you. Also, there's Malcolm X, who is an activist, which African Americans look up to. And also, Professor Antonio Inoki changed his name. And some North American fans look up to him as an inspiration as for pro wrestling, and he actually, Antonio Inoki actually innovated one of the greatest kicks in pro wrestling today, the enziguri, which was a kick to the back of the head called the enziguri, which Owen Hart used before he passed away. And another African American wrestler named Banyus Brown did a similar version of that. And you have to think about all that, people, because people who convert to Muslim, become a Muslim, can be anyone. And you see, I'm not a Muslim, but I respect the Muslim faith to a point. It says some of the things that they say I agree with, some I don't. And some of their religious garb I respect, but sometimes not as much. Like the hijab as well. So this, like I said, if I had a wife girlfriend and I want her to accept their beliefs and wear the hijab, and in return, if I had a Muslim threat, I met a Muslim in Afghanistan, and me and become friends, and he wants to learn more about America, I tell him, America and Canada, and I tell him about our beliefs, about their beliefs, can say you can wear it. I can say that you can wear the hijab, but as a safety precaution, you have to show your entire face to prove who you are. And this is Malibu Sean Bateman signing off.